stuff. So that was the Fijian class with their Mabula set. Now a little story, a little bit of info there. In the Pacific, our ancestors used to hold ceremonies and celebrate the moon. Now in Fiji, the moon cycle and the different shapes of the moon told them when to fish, harvest, and when to celebrate. And some of the world's most dedicated and talented artists come from the Pacific. These legacies are carried to us through delicately woven mats, through hand-painted tapa, the songs that speak of the beauty of our islands and history, and the oratory and stories, to name a few things. We live as one with the environment. We are guided by her and rely on her resources to sustain us. Some things that happened earlier. What do you guys think of Moemoana's Tahitian performance? Now, she recently returned from Tahiti, where she lived for 3 months to dance and study Tahitian culture and arts. She actually performed the winning choreography from the group she danced for, O Tahitie, and O Tahitie won the Haver Festival competition this year. And she has clearly brought home some skills with her. She also came second in the Fire Knife, in the World Fire Knife Championship, sorry, which was held in Hawaii. How cool is that? Fire Knife Championship. Now coming up, we will see Punawai recite their pepeha in Māori, telling you of where they come from, what mountain they belong to, and the river that sustains their tribe. Our connection to our whakapapa, or genealogy, is key to standing strong in who we are. And by the way, we are more than a fierce haka and a graceful dance. Each movement and gesture is thousands of years in the making, and a legacy gifted to us. They tell us of who we are, where we came from, and how we got here. Our ancestors knew that we would need it to help us navigate the world for generations to come.
Sama wai. Our Mother Earth, Hina, goddess of the moon, sea, and cup of making, gave birth to our island of Molokai. This would become her earthly home, known as Molokai Puleo'u, the island of powerful prayers. In ancient times, our island was spoken of with great fear and respect. It was said Hina would help our people and the wise priests that live here drive away invading armies through the united power of prayer. It is said even now that Hina will visit Molokai from the three fullest moons to bless the island and its people. And then she shall return to her resting place in the sky for the clouds with kappa. Now each time our women practice kappa, we remember our goddess Hina, our birth mother, our guiding light.
Come on, now, Aloha, yeah. Thank you.
8:53.